Hello, this video presentation will show you how to submit a Construction General Permit, also known as TRX150000, Notice of Intent Application in STEERS. The CGP NOI is submitted in TCEQ's online e-permitting system, known as STEERS. To get to the STEERS webpage, first, go to the TCEQ homepage. The TCEQ homepage can be found at www.tceq.texas.gov. The homepage has different rows of boxes to choose from. So you'll scroll halfway down the page, and on the left of the page, under the heading Online Services, select Apply for Permits and Licenses, Report, Pay Fees, and More through STEERS, Net DMR, e-licensing, e-filing, e-pay, which in this video is highlighted by a red box. And throughout the rest of the video, there will be red arrows and boxes that highlight the information discussed. Under the heading TCEQ Online Services, you'll see two rows of boxes. Go to the first row and find the last box on the right, and then select Submit Reports through STEERS, Net DMR, SUNS. This will lead you to the e-reporting page. Now that we are on the e-reporting page, look under the heading Report the Following through STEERS. Under this section, click the blue button that says Register through STEERS. After you click on the Register through STEERS, you will be taken to the STEERS homepage. You'll log into your STEERS account using your ER account number and password. If you have not created a STEERS account, under the STEERS login, it states, I need. Below that, you'll click to create a new account. If you need help creating an account, you can follow the TCEQ YouTube video, How to Set Up an Account in STEERS, or you can find instructions and regulatory guidance 531A titled A Guide to Creating an Account in STEERS. If you have previously had a STEERS account and it's archived, you'll email the STEERS help desk at steers@tceq.texas.gov. Or call the STEERS helpline at 512-239-6925 to have your account reactivated. After you have logged into your STEERS account, you will need to designate Stormwater General Permits as your program area. If you already have Stormwater General Permits designated as your program area, you can skip ahead in the video to when we begin to fill out the actual application. To set Stormwater General Permits as your program area on the STEERS homepage, in the top center portion of the screen, select My Account. In the upper right-hand corner above the STEERS logo, there is a countdown timer. Please be aware of the time. If you don't progress to the next screen by the time the timer reaches zero, STEERS will log you out. You will have to re-log in to finish the application. On this screen, it will show your account summary. Below the account summary in the section STEERS Access, there is a drop-down menu. After you select the drop-down, a list of the different program areas will appear. Select Stormwater General Permits, then select Go. On the screen, you will need to select your access type. From the drop-down next to access type, you will notice the different access types and the functions allowed by each type. In order to select stormwater sign as your access type, you must meet signatory authority, which is explained in Rule 30-TAC-305.44. Select the appropriate access type, then answer the remaining questions on this page. Then you'll select Save Changes. After selecting Save Changes, if all the information entered was correct, a message will appear in red at the top of the page stating your EPR SW access has been updated. You can make additional changes or press cancel to return to account information. The program status has been updated, however. The account is still in probationary status. Next, you will need to sign a STEERS Participation Agreement, SPA. At the top of the page, there are two options for SPA. The e-signed SPA can be used if you have a valid Class C Texas driver's license. If you do not have a valid Texas driver's license or have a valid Texas driver's license, but not a Class C license, then the paper SPA function must be used. In this video, we will show you the e-signed SPA process. Select e-signed SPA in the top right corner of the screen. On the e-sign page, the applicant will verify the account information is correct. The applicant will then read the conditions of using the STEERS account on the rest of the page. At the bottom of the e-sign page, the applicant will sign electronically using personal information. The applicant will then read and check both boxes on the statements on the bottom. Then you'll select e-sign SPA. If the information is correct after signing the SPA, a message will come up saying, "This page confirms the submittal of your electronically signed STEERS participation agreement to the TCEQ." You'll then select STEERS Home and the upper right-hand corner of the page to begin filling out the stormwater application. You'll then select Stormwater General Permits found in the middle of the page. To select a new application, select Fill Out listed on this page. Select Create a Construction Notice of Intent Application, CNOI. Then click Next at the bottom of the screen. This screen will show that the application has been created. There will be an application reference number and password, which can be used to give another STEERS user access to this application. This can be used when a secondary user needs to sign the application that the first user filled out. If needed, write down the application reference number and password. When completed, select Next. Now you will begin filling out the application. On the left side of the screen is a task list. Each item is a different part of the application. Once you have completed that portion of the application, it will be listed as done. Any unfinished portions of the applications are listed as to do. You must complete the application in order, and you cannot move on to the next portion of the application until you have completed the previous one. The question icons shown next to some questions are linked to STEERS Help. The customer can select the blue question mark icon and a new window will open, providing help text to explain what information the STEERS system is requesting. Any questions with a red asterisk next to them must be completed in order to move on to the next portion of the application. These icons will appear throughout the application process. While filling out the application, errors will come up as text, either at the top of the screen or next to the missed question. Failing to fill out a required question or the information has a validation error will cause these errors to come up. As I previously mentioned, there is a 20-minute countdown timer at the top right of the page. If the time expires, the system will log you out and you will lose the information on any page that is still in the to-do status. The timer restarts every time you complete a portion of the application. At the bottom of the customer applicant information page, is the responsible authority contact. If any of the information has changed, edit it. Then you'll select next/save. This is the application contact page. The information you fill out here is who TCEQ would contact with questions about the application. Please review the information on the page. If any of this information has changed, you'll edit it and select next/save. Now we have reached the CNOI General Characteristic page. The first question is a drop-down menu asking whether the project is located on Indian country lands. If yes is selected, you must obtain authorization from EPA Region 6 and Dallas before proceeding with this application. Otherwise, mark no if not applicable. Continue with the required questions. The question 8, you will select the type of construction project under the available column. Then once it is highlighted, you will select the top arrow icon that points to the right that is located between the two tables. That will transfer the selected highlighted type to the selected column. For questions 13 and 14, you will use the TCEQ Surface Water Quality Viewer to find this information. You can find the TCEQ Surface Water Quality Viewer by going to www.tceq.texas.gov/gis/segments-viewer. When you reach that page, click on the blue Surface Water Quality Viewer box. Once you select the Surface Water Quality Viewer box, an interactive map will appear. You will enter the site address in the upper left-hand corner box and select the magnifying glass indicating search. Once the address of the site appears on the map, you will zoom in and out until you find the nearest classified segmented body of water that receives discharge from your facility. The water bodies are highlighted in blue. Near the body of water will be a segment number as seen in the picture. Answer the rest of the questions on the CNOI page, then select next/save. Now your application is ready to be signed. Note the box indicating the reference number to the application you just completed. Noting the reference number from above, locate and check the applicable reference number box. To the far right, you will see the application is ready to sign. Click the sign button on the bottom of the page. If there is not a sign button and you have signatory authority, you need to update your account information to include signing ability. Once you have finished reading and reviewing the statement, please check both boxes and enter your STEERS ER account password. Then select Apply Electronic Signature at the bottom of the screen. The payment process of the application. Click the Pay Reference box, then click Next. Review the page, select Next. Read each step carefully. Note, click Go to ePage one time and one time only. Once ePay has been clicked, this is not the last step. After you have paid, be sure to submit your application. Select Checkout. Fill out all the information correctly, then select OK. This is your transaction information sheet. Scroll all the way down to complete. Then select Make a Payment, which will redirect you to the payment screen. Here you will enter your information and scroll down. Then you'll go to the bottom of the screen and select the green Next button. Enter your credit or debit card information, then click the green Next button. To submit payment, check the verification I'm not a robot box. Then click the green Submit Payment button. This is your receipt from ePay. You are not done with the application. You must now submit the application. It may take up to 3 business days for electronic payment to be processed and be reflected in the TCEQ ePay system. You can print this receipt for your records. Select Return to STEERS. Select the radio dial next to Submit Reference Number. Then select Next. Select the Submit button. Do not leave this screen until the processing is completed. Congratulations, you have completed your Construction General Permit Notice of Intent in STEERS. From this page, you can print out your copy of record, approval letter, and certificate by selecting the paper pictogram in the table. This is the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching.